and good morning and welcome to our Easter Sunday morning prayer, and a blessed Easter to you gathered here this morning. And it's lovely to welcome our dear sister Siobhan and Magdalena and sister Fran and those who will join me on Facebook. A blessed Easter to you and your loved ones. And what a glorious morning it is here in Cumbria. The sun is shining, though it's bitterly cold. But this morning at 5 a.m., several of our villagers of the Christian tradition climbed the hill, quite a steep hill, in Arnside to await the dawn and then begin by singing the resurrection hymn. Brother Rob and I did that 22 years ago, and it was pitch black going through the trees up to the top of the mountain, and this was this almighty face in front of me, and I let out a huge scream, and it was one of the Highland cattle that was among the bushes. Well, I couldn't forget that as long as I live. But what is so wonderful, we were gathered there, about 50 of us, waiting for the sun to rise over the Cumbrian hills and mountains and welcome the Christ. And that's what we're going to do this morning. We're going to remember the risen Christ who rose from his slumber, and who took on board all our sin. So let us begin our morning prayer. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And this morning, again, we have lit two candles. The candle behind me is dedicated to the Archangels of Peace, where we pray for the cessation of violence between Israel and Gaza. And we also remember the hostages being held in captivity since the 7th of October. And we also pray for peace in Ukraine. And we send blessings from this humble abode to all Christians around the world who are celebrating Easter Sunday morning. This Easter light is my gift to you, as I bring each one of you, with the many who've asked for prayer, for those in need of prayer, dear Sister Fran, Sister Sue, for Brother Cyril, we bring them to the risen Christ, and with all the children of God who are suffering and struggling in mind, body, or spirit. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayer. And now let us celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit to our heart. And we make some noise for God on this Easter Sunday morning. He is risen from the dead. And now we play for you a psalm. And the psalm that was chosen for us after our morning prayer, sorry, after our opening prayer, is the responsorial psalm for Easter morning. So let us now come to the complete book of Celtic prayer and share with your heart the prayer for Easter Sunday. And here it is. Jesus, who stopped the wind and stilled the waves, grant you calm in the storm times. Jesus, victor over death and destruction, bring safety on your voyage. Jesus of the purest love, perfect companion, bring guarding ones around you. Jesus of the miraculous catching of fish and the perfect lakeside meal, guide you finally ashore. Risen Christ, you burst from the grave, help us to burst into life. You breathed on your disciples. Breathe your life into us this Easter Sunday morning. Amen. Now let us play the responsorial psalm for Easter Sunday morning. And here it is. Bear with me. Just bear with me a moment. Okay. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and we are glad. What a lovely entrance responsorial psalm that Spirit chose for us this morning. We come to you now and we share with your heart one of two psalms. And the first psalm is a modern version of Psalm 34 from the book Psalms Now. I feel as if I could never cease praising God. Come and rejoice with me over his goodness. I reached for him out of my inner conflicts, and he was there. He was there to give me strength and courage. I wept in utter frustration at my troubles, and he was near to help and support me. What he has done for me, he can do for you. Turn to him. He will not turn away from you. and his loving presence encompasses those who yield to him. He is with them in the midst of their troubles and conflicts, and he meets their emptiness with his abundance and shores up their weaknesses through his divine power. Listen to me, I know whereof I speak. I have learned through experiences that this is the way to happiness. God is ever alert to the cries of his children. He feels and bears with them, their pains and their problems. He is near to those who suffer and reaches out to help those who are battered down by despair. Even the children of God can experience affliction, but they have a loving Father who will keep them and watch over them. The godless suffer in loneliness, without hope. The servant of God finds meaning and purpose, even in the midst of their suffering conflict. These are the inspired words from a loving God. Now, our next video is one I've played maybe once or twice, and it's called He Will Carry You. He Will Carry You.
Whatever you are going through at this time, God can carry you. He will carry you.
I know my brother that he
Brother and sister, and he will carry you. That's the wonderful promise that Jesus gave us. That when we call upon his name, he comes. And that whatever we ask from a loving heart, from a loving God, God will meet our needs, but never our wants. Let us come to the second psalm for morning prayer, and it's a modern version of Psalm 62. As for me, my heart waits on God. I know that my salvation comes from him. I might change my views about many things, but as for me and my God and his love, that is one conviction that shall never change. There are many who would like to sabotage a person's deepest convictions with the skillful use of words and logic. They try to destroy the very foundations of faith. And as for me and my heart, we wait on God. He is our hope and our help. And the temporal values that people focus on are so quickly lost amid the tempests of this life. Their highest aspirations burst forth like bright flares, only to fizzle out like wet fuses. But my God offers security that is eternal. It cannot be logically defined, but it can be experienced. Commit your life to the Lord your God, and you shall discover an anchor that will hold firm despite the chaos of this existence. A powerful message from a loving God. And we give praise and thanks to the Holy Spirit who chose those two psalms for the glory of God. Thanks be to you, O God. Now we have another video, and the video is called What Love Is This?
Me.
Dear friends, allow me to share with you a part of the reflection for this Easter Sunday from the book Daily Reflections for Lent and Easter by Father John Paul Thomas. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb. She came early in the morning while it was still dark. And she saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples whom Jesus loved. And she told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where to find them." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. John chapter 20, verses 1 to 3. Happy Easter! Our Lord has risen. He has overcome death, and he has opened the gates of heaven to all who believe and receive the gift of salvation. Alleluia! What a glorious day we celebrate. Let us pause there, because today is a day of celebrating with Christ, because he underwent the most horrific, agonizing death for you and for me. And he triumphed over evil. And we too will triumph over our many challenges and the influence of the evil one. When we do these things, when you are tempted, and you will be, because we have surrendered our heart to God, doesn't say we're immune from suffering or temptation from the evil one. But Jesus reminds us to call on him and to wrap the evil one in his precious blood and send him to the light. So there, let us now come to our next video. Bear with me. And I've momentarily lost it, but just let's see. It's here. Okie cokie. Right, Brother Sean. Forgive me, there's just a little turbulence, but we're getting there. Found it. Now.
Thank you.
That is a powerful video. But the last part of the video really did touch my heart, where you see the outline of Jesus come to the sinner. Spirit drew my attention to this beautiful, beautiful reflection called Easter Blessings by one of Ireland's greatest mystics, the late Father John O'Donoghue. Both Brother Rob and I have been following the teachings of Father John for a number of years, but of course he's in spirit now. But what an amazing man. Let me share with you now the Easter blessing. On this Easter morning, let us look again at the lives we have been so generously given, and let us let fall away the useless baggage that we carry, old pains, old habits, old ways of seeing and feeling, and let us have the courage to begin again. Life is very short, and we are no sooner here than it is time to depart again. And we should use to the full the time that we still have. We don't realize all the good we can do. A kind, encouraging word or helping hand can bring many a person through dark valleys in their lives. We weren't put here to make money or to acquire status or reputation. We were sent here to search for the true light of Easter in our hearts. And when we find it, we are meant to give it away generously. May the spirit and the light of this Easter morning bless us all, watch over us and protect us on our journey. Open us from the darkness into the light of peace, into the life of hope, into the life of transfiguration. Rest in peace, dear Brother John. I so love that beautiful reflection for Easter. It says it all. But you and I, like Father John, can do great things for the Lord in little ways, by sharing the smile of God with those whom you meet. Yes, you can. Let us come now to the scripture reading for Easter Sunday morning. But just bear with me a moment. I'm rather dry. Tis thirsty work reading for the Lord. So let us come now to our scripture reading. Okay. Our scripture reading is from the letter of the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, verses 40 to 42. God raised Jesus from death on the third day and caused him to appear. He was not seen by all the people, but only by us who are witnesses that God had already chosen. We ate and we drank with him after God raised him from the dead, and he commanded us to preach the gospel to the people and to testify that he is the one whom God has appointed judge of the living and of the dead. All the prophets spoke about him, saying that everyone who believes in him will have his sins forgiven through the power of his name. And the Benedictus Antiphon, very early in the morning, just after the sun had risen, they came to the tomb. Alleluia. And Spirit has chosen for us the Benedictus, the Canticle of Zechariah. So let me find it for you now. Here we are.
Thank you.
Oh, wow, what a beautiful voice. Praise you, Lord, and thank you, Holy Spirit. Let us now repeat the Benedictus Antiphon for morning prayer. Very early on the Sunday morning, just after the sun had risen, they came to the tomb. Alleluia. Let us come now to our morning intercessions. Let us pray to Christ, the author of life. God raised him from the dead, and he himself will raise you to life by his own power. Response: Christ, our life, save us. Christ, you are the light that drives out darkness and draws us to holiness. Let us make this day a living hymn of praise. Response: Christ, our life, save us. Our Master and our Brother, you have made us a kingdom of priests to serve God the Father. Let us offer you today with joy the sacrifice of praise. Response: Christ, our life, save us. King of glory, we look forward to the day of your coming. Then we shall see your face and share in your splendor. Christ, our life, save us. Let us just for a moment or two switch off the mind and ask the Holy Spirit to open the door of your heart so that you can hear and sense what is the Holy Spirit saying to you this morning. Let us be still now. Just bear with me a second. For some reason it's not come up. Oh, here we are.
Come, Holy Spirit.
just sit in the presence of Jesus. He has led us up to the Mount of Olives, overlooking Jerusalem, the city of God, the birthplace of Abraham's God, where Jew, Muslim, and Christian come together to sing the praises of God. But as you sit with Jesus, you can behold the beauty of creation, God's free gift to you this morning. Reflect on nature, and especially the animal kingdom, who will always protect you, safeguard you, touch you. And as you gaze upon the distant mountains, some have faded away, but your heart is soaring in great joy and exclamations of praise to God for offering you this free gift to sing the praises of the one you love. Below you, visualize the Good Shepherd, the one who gave his life for you. Abba, Father, in Jesus' name, we celebrate the feast of your Son's resurrection. Touch the hearts of those who've joined us in prayer this morning. Free us from all guilt, fear, and prejudice, and reawaken us to be less judgmental and more compassionate, and to embrace the weight of our own cross in a spirit of joy and gladness. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So be at peace within your heart. Focus on your in-breath, your sacred breath, and take a nice deep breath of the Christ's love for you. And in your out-breath, release gratitude to Jesus, what he's done for you, what he will continue to do for you if you are willing to trust him, if you are willing to be patient in carrying your cross, and rather than your cross own you, rather than your problems or your challenges own you, you own them by asking the Holy Spirit to give you the strength today to own whatever troubles you. And now, let us come to the Lord's Prayer. It's called the East Indian Hymn Tune. So here we go. Didn't come up. Okay, let's try again. Oh, here we are.
Our Creator, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
So we express our joy to one another on this beautiful Easter Sunday morning. But we give thanks to Christ, who offered his own life out of love. And we need to be reminded of what he did for us. He set us free from sin. He set us free from selfish love to a selfless love. And each waking moment, he calls out our name to come, to sit beside him in prayer. Let us conclude with the morning prayer from the Office of Lords. On this day, Lord God, you open for us the way to eternal life. Through your only Son's victory over death, grant that as we celebrate the feast of his resurrection, we may be renewed by your Holy Spirit and rise again in the light of life. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus the Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. This brings us now to the end of our morning celebration. And I blow the light of Christ from this Easter candle into your hearts, into the hearts of your loved ones, into the hearts of every child of God, suffering and struggling, especially in Gaza, in Afghanistan, and also not forgetting the children of God in Gaza and Israel and Ukraine. Light of Christ, thank you for touching the hearts of each one of us here. Let us go from this place of love, and let us share the smile of God with those we meet this morning or today. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and to serve a loving God. Namaste, Shalom. Inshallah, Pax et Bonum Om Shanti. Solo de Caritas. Salam Alaikum. May the peace, the love, and the joy of the Lord, which is our strength, be with you this day and every day you live. Amen. So this brings us now to the end. And our dear brother Sid has just arrived for the final blessing. Hello, good morning. He's been asleep most of the morning because he had a busy night looking for the chocolate eggs that were bought for him. Doggy chocolate eggs. And he can smell them a mile off, but he will have to wait till this afternoon. I will lead Vespers today, but it will be at 4 o'clock, not 5, because we've got Mother Olivia coming, who's on her own with Sister Jean. They're coming for their Easter Sunday dinner at 5 o'clock. So I've got to be busy preparing in the kitchen. Let us go from here. Let us celebrate. Let us give thanks to God for all that he's done for you, that he will do for you today. Now, I'm just going to play the final video, my gift, my Easter egg to you.
Turn away.
I say farewell. Thank you on this beautiful Easter morning for allowing me pray with you. Have a blessed Easter. And I look forward to your company again. But remember that you too were called by name to be a prayer partner for a loving God on earth. And our Father God will remind you every waking moment of your life that in your volunteering to be a prayer partner, he reminds you that you are royalty in his kingdom, the kingdom of heaven. Have a lovely day, dear friends. Until we meet again, God bless and happy Easter.